want to say a few words to the Warriors real quickly. I don't want to dismiss anybody, but I do want to say something to Warriors. And you can be a grandmama and still be a Warrior. Say amen. Yeah, you can still be a mother and still be a Warrior. Say amen. Yeah. A grandfather, whatever. Let me tell you this real quick. If you've been to Bible class anytime, you heard this story. There was a little dude who was from a family that God had chosen him to be king. Well, while he was chosen to be king, he had went down to a place where they were fighting. And while they were down there fighting, there was a big giant down there fighting. Y'all remember the story? While the giant is down there fighting, the people of God are sitting on the sideline. While the people of God are sitting on the sideline, the young boy who was chosen to be king walked down there to take a sandwich. Y'all ain't talking back to myself, sandwich. He went to take his brother a sandwich. That's what he was supposed to do. He was supposed to just be going down there, take a sandwich down there. So he went to take the sandwich down there, got down there where they were fighting at, saw the big old giant standing on the other side laughing at the people of God. Now, all he was there for was to bring the sandwich. When he got down there, he said, well, what's wrong with this picture? How are the people of God sitting on the sideline while the giant is laughing? And I just came to bring a sandwich. His brother told him, say, hey, man, don't be down here asking all these questions. Cut their foolishness out. Get on back to the house. He said something. He asked the question. I asked this question years ago at Lighter, where I'm asking now. I ask it every month. Is there not a cause? And at some point, we're going to have to recognize that there is a cause we're fighting for. Now, let me help you real quick, and I got about 3 more minutes. I'm going to sit on down. Here's the answer. Is there not a cause? He says, is there not a cause? Is there not a reason why we should be engaged in fighting? And all I'm saying to you, those of you of the chocolate, from the chocolate side of the city of the darker hue, is there not a reason we should be fighting? Shouldn't we be engaged in fighting? Right now, if you watch our children, our lives, we are at war with a system that's really trying to destroy us. Is there not a cause? So here's what happens. 2 things. 1, when that question is asked, the first thing it does, it challenges your comfort level. Part of our biggest problem is that we have over 180 plus homicides. We have over 400 some non-fatal shootings. And a lot of us are functioning in comfort while the enemy of God laughs at us and all the warriors on the sideline. All the warriors on the sideline. They chilling. The enemy of God is laughing and the warriors are sitting down.
Amen.
Now we can charge the system. We can charge the system for the overwhelming amount of African-American males incarcerated. We can charge the system for putting drugs and stuff in our community. We can charge the system for absent father-dependent children saying, hey, listen, hide his shoes and his toothbrush. And when I come by, act like he don't live with you. I'm going to pay your health care. I'm going to give you some food stamps. We can charge the system, but at some point, the warriors are going to have to come off the sideline.
Yeah.
At some point, the Warriors are going to have to gird up. If I was at Hovey, I'd say get some balls, but I don't want to insult nobody. At some point, the Warriors will have to gird up their loins. That sound better?
Yeah.
Gird up their loins and say, there's a fight, there's a call that I got to get in, and it's going to challenge my comfort level.
Yeah.
Here's my last thing, because I don't want to bore y'all, wear y'all out. The last thing is this. Not only does it challenge our comfort, but it commands some courage.
Yeah.
It commands some courage. And as much as I enjoy basketball, as much as I enjoy having our children out, as much as I enjoy us having fun, at some point we're going to have to get some courage and go out and fight the battle that we're really engaged in.
Yeah.
At some point we're going to have to get some courage to say, not just say it has to stop, but actively engage to make sure it stops. To get the warriors off the sideline, into the schools, into the neighborhoods, into the prisons, into the juvenile systems, into the crack houses, into the what y'all call them up here, the pee shake houses. Yeah, we call them the gambling spots. But get them in there and say, something's got to change. Young brother, go home. Old man, stop buying that. Bruh. Your son is going to the penitentiary.
Where's your daughter?
Bro, your daughter just got pregnant. At some point, we're going to have to call people home. Mama, listen. Now, listen, Mama, I love you to death. But you can't have all them kids by all those men and think it ain't going to be a problem.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't talking back to me. Listen, it's going to command some courage. We're going to have some courage to say, bro, why you got a gun at the dang on? I was at the pizza place. Guy had a big old gun. I said, bro, you got a gun to get pizza?
Amen.
Sis, give me my pizza. Let me hurry up and get out of here. This boy gonna get shot at the pizza place. At some point, we're gonna have to push people, challenge people, command them to do better. Or we'll just keep having comfort while the giant keep laughing. But listen, I believe that this is a season of people who are of the darker side of the chocolate, side of the city of the dark, as Langston Hughes would call them, that are ready to stand up and gird up their loins and take back their community. Their comfort has been challenged, and we have been commanded to be courageous. So stand up, stand proud, be outspoken, and at the same time, still love God. Please, I don't know what stopped chocolate folk from going to church. What stopped us from going to church? Who else you think got you over the big water? Who else you think helped you through 400 plus years of slavery? Who else you think was there over 100 plus years of Jim Crow and segregation? Who else was there when they flooded your neighborhood with crack cocaine? Who else was there when they built the prisons in the 90s and Bill Clinton signed the bill to lock us all up? Who else would you think grandma was praying to? When did we decide to leave God? So it's our problem to fix for ourselves. God bless you, Clyde. Thank you very much for hosting this. Shout out to Kurt Moore for having enough courage and enough faith to say, yeah, I'm in the hood, but I still love God. Y'all keep praising God and keep honoring him. God bless you.
Dr. Posley.